Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that what is Nernst equation and what are the formula related to it. So now we are going to derive or we are going to find out what would be the answer when the numerical is based on Nernst equation. So let us see how can we find out. So the question which is on your screen says that write the cell reaction and calculate the standard potential of cell. The cell is given in this way, and in this case E naught of, that is standard EMF of the chlorine, is given as plus 1.36 volt, while the standard cell potential, that is E naught of Ni, is given as minus 0.25. So we have to calculate the standard potential of the cell. So before finding out the standard potential of the cell, we have to know that which one is acting, which electrode is acting as anode and which electrode is acting as a cathode. So we could directly estimate from this cell that what would be the anode and what would be the cathode. But the first of all thing that we should know is we have to write the cell reaction. So how can we write? The cell reaction involves two processes, that is one is oxidation and one is reduction. So in this case, whenever a cell formula is being provided to us, it should be clearly known that according to IUPAC, the electrode which is present on the left side of the cell formula is said to be an anode, or which acts like an anode. While in this cell or in this formula, where the electrode which is on the right side of the cell formula is acting like a cathode. So in this formula, because of which we have recently got to know that which one is acting like anode and which one is acting like a cathode. So because of that, we could write the cell reaction very easily now. So how can we write? Let's see. So according to the cell diagram that we have, or cell formula, we have observed that the anode is nothing but the one which is present on the left hand side, which is nickel, and the cathode will be the one which is present on the right hand side. So in this case, the platinum is being used, but the platinum is used as an inert electrode on which the Cl2 gas, or that is chlorine gas, is acting as a cathode. So therefore I could write it as Cl2 platinum in this way. In this case, the platinum has no role of getting decomposed or of getting deposition of some few elements on it, because the main thing is Cl2 is acting like a cathode in this case with the help of platinum rod. So because of this thing, we could write the cell reaction very much easily. How? Because at anode, as you know, at anode always oxidation occurs, so in this case the electrode, that is nickel, which is present, it will get oxidized, and the nickel oxidizes two electrons to form Ni2+. So therefore it will form Ni2+ in aqueous form, while this nickel will be in solid form, plus two electrons. So this is the reaction, this is a one reaction or half reaction of a species that is undergoing oxidation. So we have to write now the second half reaction, that is for chlorine. So at cathode, always reduction takes place, and in this case Cl2 is being formed, or Cl2 gets deposited on the cathode. So that means the aqueous form of chlorine atoms are being, or chlorine ions are being involved, so that they could accept electron, so that they could form the Cl2 gas molecules. So in this case, to form Cl2 gas molecules, Cl minus ions, that is chloride ions, will accept electron or will undergo oxidation process. When Cl2 is being formed, it will accept two electrons when it undergoes reduction. So this is not possible if Cl minus will accept two electrons to form Cl2. So in this case, Cl2 will accept 2 electrons to form Cl minus ions, and that also 2 moles of Cl minus ions. So this is what the overall reaction, or this is what the reaction of half cells that is based on oxidation and based on reduction. So this is the first data that we have calculated, and we have determined, or we have said that what would be at oxidation and what would be the reaction during the reduction. So now let us see that what would be the standard cell potential when this all data are been provided to us. So in this case, where nickel is acting like anode and the chlorine atoms in this case are acting like cathode in this case. So therefore, the anode would be the nickel, and while that of the chlorine atoms or this half cell will act like a cathode. So we know that the cell standard cell potential is nothing but it is a difference between the electrode cell potential of cathode minus the standard electrode cell potential of the anode. So therefore we could write it as E naught cell will be equals to E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. So in this case, the chlorine atom was acting as a cathode. So therefore the cathode value, that is E naught of cathode value, was found to be plus 1.36 volt minus that of the anode. In this case, the nickel was acting like an anode. So the value of the standard EMF of the nickel was found to be minus 0.25. So therefore, if I calculate this thing, so I could get it as 0.25. So if I 0.25 volt. So therefore, if I calculate this thing, I could get the answer as 1.61 volt. So this is the overall E naught or standard EMF of the cell of this reaction or of this cell. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got an idea how to calculate the EMF cell or EMF of the cell as well as the standard EMF of the cell. So thank you so much, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel and share this video with your friends too. Thank you so much.